Hey Sam, hey Soft, it's Mainly Butch, Ange, coming at ya from the woods of Maine, where the coyotes howl, ow, and they are howling tonight, baby, let me tell you, there's a pack of them out here. You picked my interest with your video about the long-term relationship and possibility of it ending or changing. It's a really hot topic with me, actually. For those of you who know me a little bit, you'll know that I was in a 14-year marriage that ended about 2.5 years ago. And personally, I want to tell you, you know, that you question yourself every day over did you do the right thing. You spend a lot of time with somebody, in my case 14 years, and they become not only your lover and your confidant, but they become your best friend. They become somebody who knows you better than anybody else in the world, somebody that you seek comfort from, and somebody that's just there for you all the time. You know, that person and you are family, and you become so entwined in each other's lives that when it does end, if it ends, the untangling of those lives can take years itself, I believe. I've just come to a point probably in the past year where I've really, you know, started to honestly look at what happened with me and what happened in my relationship, you know. And I think in my case, you know, we started to grow at some point, probably 3 years before it ended, you know, we started to grow in different directions, and in different ways. You know, it's not like, you know, she wanted to go off and do this and I wanted to go off and do that. It's just that, like, mentally we started to grow in some of these different ways and started to look at different areas of our lives that I think, you know, what was important to me wasn't as important to her, and what was important to her wasn't as important to me, and the mutual goal somehow got lost. When you're in a long-term relationship, there's generally some mutual goals, you know, and those goals develop, you know, in the first couple of years of the relationship, and then they become, you know, what sort of drives the relationship, in my opinion, into its long-term type of stuff. You know, you have these goals together, whether they be just to grow old together or what they may be. They could be a variety of things. Then, you know, if one of you loses sight of those goals, then the relationship gets in trouble. And, you know, also, the other thing I think that happens in long-term relationships is you get to know each other so well that you know what you can and cannot talk about with each other. And then you, if you get to a point, you know, where you start to grow in a different direction, you start to compartmentalize your life, and you and your life in one compartment is going over here and doing this, but you still have the compartment that's home, you know, in the long-term relationship with the partner. Once you've compartmentalized your life too much, I think things start to fall apart. And, you know, I know in my case, you know, it seemed to happen really fast and unexpectedly, but as I think back on it, it actually happened fairly slow and over a period of time that we lost sight of things together, and neither one of us wanted to admit that. And thus, we lived in harmony, and I think it, to some degree, even though things were harmonious on the surface, I think there was an undercurrent of turmoil in each of us over certain things. And that undercurrent, you know, became a tsunami at one point and blew things apart. But I was just, you know, really interested to reply to that topic. You know, I think that relationships take a lot of work on both parts. And depending upon the dynamics of the relationship, the type of relationship it is, the strength of the people in the relationship, you know, things can last a really long time. They can end, they can restart. And, you know, obviously the biggest thing is communication, but we're not always that good at communication. So, you know, we got to remember we communicate not only with our words, but we communicate with our actions and our body language and our eyes and the way we tilt our head. We communicate with so many different parts of ourselves. And I think that, you know, when you get into a stressful situation, you tend to even more accentuate those other communication means, the nonverbal ones. And I know, you know, some recent conversations that I've attempted to have with somebody else in my life have kind of gone awry because I see this horrible body stance, this horrible signals to me that this person doesn't understand what I'm talking about and doesn't get it, and, you know, and or doesn't want to talk about it. And that frustrates me because I see it not in their words, but I see it in their actions. So anyway, that was a really good topic. I hope you two are doing good tonight. All right, you have a good one. Okay, peace.